Hello everyone, I hope you guys are doing well. So I'm Shubham and you're watching Let Create an App. So in this video we are going to talk about how we can create a cool animations to make our UI looks better, and this will also enhance the user experience as we did in our past two videos, that is our slide up menu video and a chain animation video. So if you didn't watch that video, please go and watch that video. The link of the videos are mentioned in the description as well as on the I button. So in this video, let's look what we are going to learn. So there are two labels. So as I tap anywhere on the screen, these labels are gone vanished with some cool animation effect. So these two labels are vanished with some cool animation effect. So we can use this kind of a thing in our applications to make a user experience much more better as compared to the static labels or hiding and showing anything. And apart from that, if you want to learn Flutter, so I'm also starting Flutter on this channel. So these are some demos which I'm working on. So let's let these demos work first complete, then I'll show the demos. And if you want to learn Flutter and iOS application development, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. And if you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button and share the video. Let's create an app. So open an Xcode, click on single view application, click on next, and give the whatever name you want to give. I'm just giving fade animation, something like this. Now click on next and create this project where you want to create. Now our project is created. Now let's move to the storyboard first and design a simple basic layout which we have saw in the demo application. So for that we have to take two labels, and the first is this label, this one, and just copy this label by pressing alt key. Now let's put the text which we want to show in this label. So I'm just going to create let create an app, this thing. Now this label is coming in the single line. Now let's make this label in coming in two lines. So let's make this number of lines to be two, and just reduce the size of this label first. So this will come up with the two lines, and increase the font size of this label to like 30, maybe good size. Yeah, this one, like this. Now let's write something on this label. So I'm just typing a simple text. So we have just set up these two things, two labels. Now let's make these two labels first, put this thing in a stack. And for putting these two things on a stack, just click on this thing and we have to select this stack view. So as we select on this stack view, this will come up with this kind of scenario. So we need to rearrange this thing according to our need. So let's put the constraints to this stack view. And if you don't know how to use stack view, you can go and watch my stack view video. The link of the stack view video was mentioned in the description. So just put two constraints, center, horizontal and vertical, something like this. And as we see that the leading and trailing are just minus minus something, so we need to make these things a positive 20, and this is also positive 20. So as I put the constraints, and this will come up with a completely fine thing. So these are completely working fine. Now let's add a little bit more constraint so that we can get this thing working correctly, something like this. But still this is not coming in two lines, so you can increase the font size a little bit, so then it will come up in two lines. So this is a very easy thing which we can do. And I guess there is a little bit more spaces, so this is 32. Let's change it to 20, or we can also with 10. Yeah, so this is looking cool. Now let's change a little bit to color is orange. So this is exactly looking the same whatever we have in our demo application. Now let's move to the storyboard class, this view controller class. Now it's a coding time. We will now do some coding to put the animations. I'm just creating the labels of this thing. So label one, I'm just giving a very simple names. Label two, So let's do some coding in this viewDidLoad first. So let's first close this thing and just move to the storyboard, because just move to the view controller because we don't need storyboard anymore. Now first we have to put a gesture recognizer so that whenever user tap on view, it will perform some action. So for adding a gesture, let gesture UI tab gesture recognizer, and in this target itself, and in the selector we have to use selector something like this. So on click view, something like this. Now we have to add this tab gesture on this self.view.add gesture recognizer, and in this we have to pass a gesture something like this. Now we have to create one method of @obgc type, and the name of this method should be like this, the same thing which we have written over here, and I've just created a method with the same name over here. So our gesture is now added on the view, so whenever user tap on this view, this will call this function. Now we have to do some animation coding, that how we can create this kind of animation. So just simply we need to use our UIView.animate. So in this we are going to use this physical spring method. As I have told all these things in the previous two videos, that why we are using this physical spring method, because this will provide extra functionalities to us. So we have to use this thing. So the time interval should be like 0.5, and the delay is nothing, 0.0, and the using spring velocity. So what is this spring velocity? I've already told in the previous video, and the initial velocity is still the same thing which we are told in the previous video. So the option is now we are using curve is an out, and in the animation block. So in this animation block, we have to transform this thing, the bold text which we have in the system. So the text is just like label1.transform, and in this we have to just use a CGAFindTransform, and in this we have to just translate this x and y position of this label. So it is showing an error that we need to put a self over here. So simply self like this. So whatever the x position of that cell, that label, it will shift that label to minus 25 position, and y will remain 0. So it will move this label from its current position to this position, and as soon this animation will complete, this animation completion block will call, and in this block we have to write the code to fade that animation or to move that label from bottom to top. So till now we are just moving that label from center to a left. Now we will move that label from left to top with fade animation. So we have to simply use the same thing, UIView.animation, and in this we have to use the same thing. So now the time interval is remains the same, 0.5, and delay is 0.0, and the spring velocity is still 1 in this scenario, and the velocity is 1. The animation is dot curve is an out, and in the animation block we have to first reduce the alpha of this label self.label1.alpha is equals to 0, and now we have to change that this transform for this label 1. So label1.transform is equals to CGAFindTransform, simply like this. Or we are not going to use CGAFindTransform in this thing. We have to translated it this thing. So self dot label 1 dot transform, I guess, transform dot translate, I guess this is, yeah, translate by. So this one, so this will method help us to translate this thing on the new coordinates. So for x it will be 0, and for y we need to move this thing 200 pixels above. So simply like this. So this will give a animation to us that it will fading down like nil. So let's run and check that it is working fine or not, as we have seen in the demo application. So till this is running and this will launching an simulator, these animations help us to create various simple things to look more better in our application. So our simulator is just run, and this is coming on the single line, so you can manage this thing and change according to your need. And just click on view. So as I click on this view, this will move a little bit left and then will at the top. So we have done this thing on the single label. We have to do the same thing on this label also. So for doing the same thing in this label, we have to simply move to this over here, and in this we have to write the same thing again, UI view. We have to copy this same thing, just copy this thing and paste it over here. The only difference is that we have to delay this label a 0.5 seconds, because the 0.5 seconds is when this animation block will running. And in this, this is a label 2, not label 1. This is also label 2, label 2 again. And yeah, that's cool, that's completely cool. So first this label will move to left, and when this label moved to left, this label is start moving from right to left, and it will move from the top and just fade it away. So let's run this thing and check that it is working fine or not. I guess this will working fine because it's very easy. Yeah, there is an issue that we have just didn't change this thing to label 2. So let's run again and check that now it's working fine or not. A little bit mistakes didn't make us to that functionality works completely. So this is done completely fine. I'm not going to create a functionality so that it will come back as we have in the demo. But yeah, if you download this project, then you will get that thing in that project. So I'll post that project in GitHub repository. You can download this thing from the GitHub. So this is for today. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. And if you're new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thank you.